Another edition of Crossviews. We want to thank you so very much for being faithful to one of your favorite programs, Crossviews. And on this day, we have a panelist of three gentlemen, including you out there, who are going to make things very open to Cameroonians. First of all, I want to welcome Mr. Njomo Cyril. You are highly welcome to Crossviews today.
Thanks, Mr. Mambo Williams. Good evening to my co-panelists. It's always a pleasure to share this panel midweek with the most charismatic young university doctor in the person of Dr. Busi Enes. But today we are also having the grace to be in the company of the practicing legalist or lawyer, Mr. Sebastian Kufo. And to you, Mr. Nwamu Williams, I'm so delighted that I'm part of those to take your question tonight. And to you, hundreds and thousands of viewers viewing us in Moliko, in Bokwato, and in other parts of Africa, want to tell you, you are welcome to this festive period of your evening. Then behind the camera, permit me also, Nwamu, to seize this opportunity to extend a hand of encouragement to all those who are behind the camera, making sure that our viewer back home should have a pleasant image. I would like to comment on the utterances, what I call the ugliness of the revolution that is now claiming youth life. At the day when we were celebrating the International Youth Day today, I was part of the conference organized by the African Youth Envoys of the African Union Department, and we were talking about how young people can be included in governance and by extension for the public service. I come to think that it is these young people that are perpetrating violence in various communities around the world. The question we want to ask ourselves, what is radicalizing them up to the point that they don't more have that consciousness of human life, which is sacrosanct. And I really start the program today with a heavy heart, and I pray that as we talk through, it's going to get lighter.
Yes, maybe our viewers would like to know your board, the president of Cameroonese and movement. We hear you are planning for a protest against the government for keeping the detainees, the Anglophone detainees, up to now.
Mr. Rambo, our position as far as the Yaoundé administration is concerned is known by so many. We have always been calling on the Bias regime to release the Anglophone so that it can de-escalate the ongoing crisis that has been rocking the Northwest and the Southwest. And because more and more the Yaoundé administration have decided to be using but soft technique. For example, today the young man from Bamenda who came up with a small prototype of aeroplane. Yeah, was invited at the presidency. From a very naive perspective, it will look like a very big gesture, but when you ask yourself, so many have been received like him, but what has been the way forward? We think that Cameroonians should not be distracted at a time when more and more young people are killed, and a direct answer should be given to them. When people ask us, but you keep asking for peace. If you were in the place of the head of the state, what can you do? We ask them, but why is it so difficult, even at a time when the United Nations held a security council and asked that temporarily to accompany the COVID-19 repose measure, they should release prisoners from various prisons in Cameroon. Mr. Biya decided to release only a handpick, and the Anglophone that are being detained unjustly, I should say, some are in prison up to today just because they advocated at the time for federalism.
Okay, but some people say a gesture is better than none.
The worst that some have already been tried, as we talk like this, they have been tried and sentenced given to them because they stood for secession. Okay. And I'm telling you that these are form of state that can be debatable. And if you go back to the 1996 constitution that came out after the tripartite and the all Anglophone general conferences, you will see that these were issues that were debated in that era.
And it's because it has not been put to practice that the questions are being raised again by another generation.
Okay, let me introduce Dr. Busi. Dr. Busi is a lecturer of the University of Boya. We hear 6 billion from has been released by Bia's government for universities to use for, is it COVID-19? So how far?
Mr. Mwambo Williams, I want to first of all greet my co-panelists, Mr. Njomo Siri of the CRM party, a dynamic young politician, a busy politician. I want to also greet the legal mind, Barrister Kufo, and everyone behind the camera, and Mr. Moderator. Mr. Moderator, the issue of COVID-19 has been dreadful. And it is not today that the universities in Cameroon have been struggling to combat COVID-19. As the case of the University of Boya, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Boya, because the University of Boya has been struggling to see that COVID-19 kits are stationed all over the campus, and we could see everywhere in the university, every amphi have savon and water in the university, and before you enter the university gate, your temperature is being tested. To say that university dons have been doing a lot, and university administrators have been doing a lot to combat COVID-19. So it's not a new case. If Mr. Bia is adding that, it's a positive largesse. But concerning issues that are happening in our country today, Mr. Moderator, there are a lot of issues that are happening in Cameroon today. And first of all, I want to appreciate young talent, because today is being 12th August is being celebrated as International Youth Day by the United Nations. And I want to use this opportunity to salute youths who are engaged into creativity. And I want to salute the young Cameroonian youth who the Prime Minister, Head of Government, received him, and the Presidency also received him for his creative knowledge in making an aeroplane, a prototype of an aeroplane. That's creativity. That's the kind of transformative learning I've been crying here that we need. Our educational system should be more transformative. It should not be theoretical. It should be more pragmatic. And also, Mr. Moderator, I want to join my hands with Mr. Njomo Siri to psychically condemn the brutal, the gruesome, the inhuman killing of the young lady in Moyoka. This is not what those leaders of the Anglophone, the Dr. Fontaine, the barrister, the Dr. Fontaine and others, this is not what they started decrying for. When the Anglophone crisis started in late 2017, we could see Barrister Felix Kongo and others, they were struggling to fight for the rights of the Anglophone in legal issues and also in educational issues. But when the crisis started to an extent, we saw some leaders who came from some leaders abroad who were called the Naira 10.